Thank you, Lord. He belonged to you. He belonged to you. You gave him to us for a time, but we appreciate the time that you gave him to us. So, Lord, he's in your presence now. And we thank you for that truth. Can we say thank God? Thank God.
Yeah. receive something that can make all the difference in where you spend eternity. God bless you this morning.
Come and give the Lord another hand, praise. God is worthy. He's worthy. Hallelujah. Let us give the Lord this place. We come to rejoice. We come to happen by the name of the Lord. For the scripture reading, we're going to ask that all of that are here except for the family, if you would again stand for the reading of the Old Testament and New Testament scripture. So all of them except the family, once again stand for the reading of God's word. The Old Testament reading will be found in Psalm, the 116th division of Psalm, verses 1 through 15. Psalm 116, 1 through 15. I love the Lord, because he hath heard my voice and my supplications, because he hath inclined his ear unto me. Therefore will I call upon him as long as I live. The sorrows of death compassed me, and the pains of hell gat hold upon me. I found trouble and sorrow. Then called I upon the name of the Lord. O Lord, I beseech thee, deliver my soul. Gracious is the Lord, and righteous. Yea, O God, is merciful. The Lord preserveth the simple. I was brought low, and he helped me. Return unto thy rest, O my soul. For the Lord hath dealt bountifully with me. For thou hast delivered my soul from death, mine eyes from tears, and my feet from falling. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. I believed, therefore have I spoken. I was greatly afflicted. I said in my haste, all men are liars. What shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me? I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows unto the Lord now in the presence of all his people. Precious, precious, precious is the sight in the sight of the Lord, is the death of his saints. Amen. The Lord bless the means of his word.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. This morning I'll be reading from the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verses 5 through 9. Be careful for nothing, but everything in prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned receive and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. May the Lord have a blessing to the reading of his holy word. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you, Father. And at this time, we will receive a selection from the Stoplight Church Choir. God bless you. Bless you, Father. Thank you. now it's time for our acknowledgments and resolutions. I'm here asking that Congress Lyles will come now.
Acknowledging that Deacon Jimmie Hicks, Sr. was released from the confines of time and to the reward of eternal life on Friday, January 24, 2014. We, the Starlight Church of God in Christ, take the opportunity to honor his memory and offer our earnest prayers to the entire Hicks family. Whereas, we are privileged to watch Deacon Hicks' love for his family, he firmly believed they were an inheritance and blessing from the Lord. We love them sincerely, supporting and encouraging them. He loved them, supporting and encouraging them at every opportunity. Whereas Deacon Hicks was a faithful member who loved the Lord and his church family, he willingly served in many areas of the ministry. We are grateful that he applied his gift of wisdom as head of the trustee board. He earnestly cared for the church as a member of the deacon board. He landscaped, painted, and cleaned throughout the building. Although he was a man of few words, each Sunday he used the reading of scripture to turn our hearts toward God. During this time, he would often share testimonies of the way God was blessing him. He was truly heart, all of you who hope in the Lord. According to Psalms 31 and 24, we will rely on Jesus for comfort as we mourn. We will strive to follow Deacon Hicks' example, to serve the Lord Jesus with all our hearts, to give cheerfully, to praise the Lord in all times, to walk by faith, continually growing in the fruit of the Spirit, and to remain steadfast in our trust of the Lord. We celebrate Deacon Jimmie Hicks' life and will cherish his legacy that remains. Lovingly submitted, Elder Jimmie Hicks, Jr., Pastor, the Start Right Church of God in Christ. We also have one from that reads, to Jimmie Hicks, Jr. and family, how sweet it is at evening after a long and well-spent day to close the eyes unto slumber and rest from the toils of the day. Such is the departure of Deacon Jimmie Hicks, Sr. after a long and useful life. The Ohio North First Ecclesiastic Jurisdiction Church of God in Christ recommends the Hicks family to ever lean upon the everlasting arms of Christ Jesus, who can and will heal all sorrows. Our hearts are saddened to learn that your father had taken a journey home to God, and we extend our profound sympathy and share your loss, and extend our sincere love and prayers, knowing that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Our prayers are with you. Prayerfully submitted, this first day of February, the year of our Lord, 2014, Bishop Edward T. Cook, Ohio North, and Mother Thelma Butts, Supervisor, and Sister Smith, Jurisdictional Secretary. Resolution of respect for Deacon Jimmie Hicks, Sr. In our time of loss, we can sometimes find ourselves overwhelmed with feelings of confusion and sorrow. Hopelessness and despair may well up in our hearts, and it can be seen as though comfort is beyond our reach. But as Jesus Christ tells us, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted, in Matthew 5 and 4. We all know that it is because of the resurrection that we will one day see our loved one again, and it is for this reason we can have hope and blessed assurance. Whereas in the providence of God, He has brought to us to a close the life of Deacon Jimmie Hicks, Sr., the officer and member of Messiah Ministry, Church of God in Christ, feel that it is befitting to express our sympathy to the family. We commend you to him who knows that you have our condolences. Be resolved that we bow in humble submission to him who never makes a mistake. Family, we ask that as you read this poem, you hear Deacon Hicks' voice in your ear. Don't grieve for me, now I'm free. I'm following the path God laid for me. I took his hand when I heard him call. I turned my back and left it all. I could not stay another day to laugh, to love, to work and play. Task left undone must stay that way. I found my peace at the close of day. In my parting has left a void. Now filled it with remembered joy. A friendship shared, a laugh, a kiss, and yes, these things I too will miss. Be not burdened with time of sorrow. I wish the sunshine of tomorrow. Lift up your hearts and share with me. Pastor Justine Lockhart, the Messiah Man of the Homegoing Church of God in Christ. Resolution. Our beloved Deacon Brother Jimmie Hicks, Sr. from the Lake Erie District. Whereas we, the Lake Erie District, do hereby send our resolution to the family of our beloved Deacon Brother Jimmie Hicks, Sr. this first day of September 2014. Whereas we, the Lake Erie District, send our sincere and deepest sympathy to Mother Beatrice Hicks, Pastor and First Lady Hicks, Jr., Darlene, Lynette, and the entire Hicks family, and the Startright Church family. Though Brother Hicks' smile is gone forever, and his hands we cannot touch, we will always have sweet memories of the brother we love and enjoy being around so much. Being known this day, how we observe Brother Hicks as an example of thankfulness to God, his family, and support to his son's church, Brother Hicks loved God and enjoyed being around the saints of God. Whereas we, the Lake Erie District, will keep the entire Hicks family in our prayers and pray that God will give each of you comfort in the time of sorrow. Wherefore, be it resolved that we will keep Brother Hicks' memory in our hearts, where he can now say, like Paul, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Wherefore, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearance. We are praying for each of you, the Lake Erie District, Superintendent Pastor Nash, Pastor Curtis, Pastor Gamble, Pastor Hicks, Pastor Ward, and the district missionary, Veronica McCreary, and all the First Ladies.
Amen. Amen.
Winford Church of God in Christ, resolution. God was walking in his garden, one he made with his hands. The sun was shining on each blossom, young and old, throughout all lands. In your church, he walked still searching for a lovely full-grown flower. Pausing here, he found one ready to be taken at that hour. Whereas it has been the will of God and his omnipotence to remove from our presence this life of Deacon Jimmie Hicks, Sr. And whereas by his committed and loyal attendance to the Startright Church of God in Christ has left a most worthy example to follow. And whereas the church, Startright Church of God in Christ family has lost a consecrated member, and we hereby express our appreciation for his Christian life. Be it resolved that we, the Winford Church of God in Christ, bow submissively to the will of him who doeth all things well. We, along with Pastor and First Lady Hicks, Mother Hicks, and entire Hicks family, and members of the Startright Church of God in Christ, deeply mourn over the loss of Deacon Jimmie Hicks, Sr., who is asleep upon the Savior's breast. Dear Hicks and Startright family and relatives, do not weep. Deacon Hicks is at rest. He was lent to you and to all of us just for a short while. Now Deacon Hicks, Sr., is singing with the angels and the light of Jesus' smile. Be it resolved further that a copy of this resolution be given to family and a copy kept on record for the church. Prayerfully submitted this first day of February in the year of our Lord 2014. Pastor Dennis and First Lady Geraldine Ritchie and the Winfield Church membership. Ohio, North Church of God in Christ, the jurisdictional adjutancy. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. not to be holy, but unto all them also that love his appearing. 2 Timothy 4:6-8. It is with deep sympathy you mourn and share the loss of Deacon Jimmie Hicks, Sr. Inasmuch as it pleased the Lord to call from earth to glory our dear brother, we, the Ohio North First Jurisdictional Adjutant Corporation, bow our heads in humble submission to God and say yes to his will. He was loved and respected and was truly leader. To Pastor Jimmie Hicks Jr. and the entire Hicks family and the entire Start Right Church of God Christ family, we are praying for you in your hour of sorrow. His Lord said unto him, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many. Enter thou into the joy of the Lord. Matthew 25:21. Humbly submitted this first day of February in this year, the Lord, 2014. Bishop Edward Cook, jurisdictional Reverend, Reverend Dennis Ritchie, Senior Adjutant Chief, Reverend Jimmie E. Hooks, Jr., Adjutant Scribe. I apologize, I'm not recognizing Pastor Hicks if I forgot anybody. Please forgive us for all those that sent resolutions. Amen.
Come on, can we exalt the Lord in here? Come on, put your hands. Amen. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. The Bible says that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Thank God for joy. Thank God for the joy of salvation. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And if you are saved, you don't have to be born today. Amen. Amen. That's a witness of where we're all going. Thank you, Jesus. Ain't nobody in here going to avoid this thing. Going his way. Amen. 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 So we got to learn how to rejoice for one another. How to be grateful. Thank you, Lord, for the plan and the purpose that God has for each and every one of us. Amen. It's God's plan. It's his purpose. Hallelujah. By his grace, we're coming in line. Now we'll have the obituary by Sister Linda Stevens. Can you give God praise for her as she comes? Good. Good. We're going to keep it moving. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord.
Praise the Lord. And I thank God for my Uncle Jimmy. I didn't talk to him a lot, but there were those times that I would call for my auntie and I would give him and we would talk. Okay? We get carried away sometimes too. And then he'd say, oh yeah, you talk to your auntie. Well, I'll tell her you come. Here she comes now. But anyway, Jimmie Hicks, James Hicks Sr., left time and entered eternity on Friday, January 24th, 2014, after courageously battling cancer for 10 years. Jimmie was born on September 23, 1933, in Cleveland, Ohio, to Maddie Hutchinson and Thomas Hicks, both of whom preceded him in death. Jimmie was the youngest of three children. His brother Leonard and sister Dolores will cherish his memory. Jimmie's grade school education began in R.D. Hayes Elementary School and commenced on June 12, 1952, at East Technical High School, where he enjoyed being on the track team. In 1953, he enlisted in the United States Air Force, serving at Edwards Air Force Base in Minnesota. During his term, he traveled to Japan and served in the Korean War. He was honorably discharged in 1957. In 1958, Jimmie met and married the love of his life for 55 and a half years, Beatrice Marie Hicks. To this union were born three children, Darlene Denise, Lynette Marie, and Jimmie Jr. Jimmie was a devoted family man. In 1973, he moved his family to the city of Cleveland Heights to offer them a better way of life. Jimmie was a great provider. In 1959, John C. Reardon employed him as an expediter. His job was to help maintain product quality, and he enjoyed his work. While there, he was also a member of the company's softball team. He remained in their employ until the doors closed in 1981. His diligent job search led to his employment at Trade Drive. Jimmie remained there until he retired in 1998. When asked by co-workers, "What will you do now?" he replied, "I'm taking my grandkids to Disneyland." And he did just that. And I was jealous, okay? Jimmie loved town. He was a disciplined man, saving and planning for trips near and far. He had superb navigation skills. When you traveled with him, you were sure to reach your destination. With his wife by his side, he experienced many adventures throughout North America and abroad. They were members of AARP and traveled with the Great Day Tours. In 2008, he achieved his dream of traveling to Hawaii for their 50th anniversary. So let that be a lesson. You gotta stay married. Okay. In the early 2000s, Jimmie made eternal traveling plans by accepting Jesus as his Lord and Savior. He frequently attended Central Bible Baptist Church in Cleveland Heights, as well as his childhood church, Mount Hermon Baptist. In 2006, he joined Start Right, Church of God in Christ, under the pastorate of his son, Jimmie. Joyfully served as the chair of the trustee board and as a hard-working deacon. Every Sunday, he enjoyed reading the scripture to the congregation and collecting the offering. His motto was, "God loves a cheerful giver." He will be remembered for his dedication to the church and his job speaks. One of Jimmie's greatest achievements was his sobriety of 30 plus years. He made himself available to help others break the cycle of alcoholism by serving as an AA sponsor. Jimmie was a caring and friendly man. He regularly donated blood to the American Red Cross. He was a member of the Father's Club of Captain Arthur Roth, stepping in as a neighborhood dad for many children. In his leisure, he enjoyed meeting friends for coffee at the neighborhood McDonald's, as well as daily mall walking at Richmond Mall. He loved to collect coins and all things related to boats and sailing. Jimmie leaves to cherish his memory, his devoted wife, Beatrice, his children, Darlene, Terrence, Reddick, Lynette, Michael Hughes, of Atlanta, Georgia, Jimmie Jr., Linda Hicks, nine grandchildren, Lakeisha, Alicia, Terrence, Jarvis, Northcutt, Jimmie, Imani Hicks, III, Christopher, Michael, Terrence, II, Stephen, and Jonathan, four great-grandchildren, Tyler, Ryan, Corey, and Jarvis Jr., siblings, Leonard Hicks, and Dolores Johnson, and a host of family and friends. For my life, when I look at all we have, a happy home, beautiful memories, and a bright future, I realize just how much our life has been blessed, and how much of it I have you to thank for, which includes three wonderful children and eight overnight at their house. And he always told me how much he loved his wife. He never called her Beatrice or your Auntie Bebe or your aunt. I love my wife. And one day, I'm going to go to church and I'm going to be saved. My wife goes to church all the time. So I'm just saying that to say that, yes, Bebe went to church all the time. Yes, she did. Yes, she did. And I thank God for my Auntie Bebe because she's been an example to all of us. And she led her husband to want to come to Christ. He didn't come to church. We should be an example, and she was an example. And he did come to Christ. Thank you, Lord, and we'll all see him again. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Now it's time for another selection from this great choir.
Amen. Come on, can we receive them with a hand clap of praise?
Oh, yes.
you, Lord. Amen. And now it is time for acknowledgments. No, excuse me. For words of expression. Hallelujah. From family and friends. We're asking if you could just keep your expressions to a 2-minute limit. Just for the sake of time. Amen. So we invite you to come. Oh, okay. And we do have a... I'm sorry. Come to you. Hallelujah.
Speaking on behalf of the grandchildren, I'm the first grandson, what she often said all the time, me and Keisha, we hold down number one. many memories, lots of memories, a lot of good times. And I got two funny stories. And, you know, my grandfather, he loved to travel. And we went to Disney World, Universal Studios, Busch Gardens, Hershey, Pennsylvania, Williamsburg, Virginia. I don't know why he loved that. But it was fun. I mean, we learned some history. But that was, you know, it was all right. I think we liked the roller coasters better. But, I mean, we went everywhere, and I think that stuck with us. It let us build relationships as cousins more, tight-knit family. It was all about family at the end of the day.
Yeah.
And so, I think this year we're at Busch Gardens. Oh, rewind. So when we went to these vacations, we would stay in condos. When my grandfather got a computer, I don't think anybody knew what they was doing. He would be down there on the World Wide Web, dial-up internet, whatever. He had one of these first computers. So he went, and we would stay in condos. These big town, he would find out somebody that was renting them out, and we stay in condos. We had the condo, everybody piled in, sleeping on top of each other, everything. And we used to have these water gun wars. And it would be, you know, my Uncle Michael and Chris, and me and my dad, and then Stevie and Stevie and TJ used to defect to either team, you know what I mean? It wasn't, you know, they just wanted to have the most fun, and Terrence just didn't want to get shot with the water gun. And Keisha and Nene, Keisha was a track star, and Nene, she was there. She didn't want to get shot with the water gun, this girl, you know? But Papa will always say, don't you shoot this water gun in the house when he was, you know, because he paid for it, and that's in his mind. He got one in the water then, and we had a screen door, and we said we would run by, squirt, in the house. Hey, don't y'all be shooting the water then. But it was one time, and we had this inflatable whale, and I guess he saw us having fun. I'm having some fun too. This was a whale, and he saw other people try to conquer this whale to get on it, and I guess he just thought he had the best approach. He was gonna jump on it. From the side, but we all watching, and we had a video camera set up. And I don't know how somebody got this perfect picture. It's him just falling, but he jumps on the whale and it sits for a second, and all of a sudden it just like, and he goes under, and we are crying like, man, we were literally crying. I mean, I think TJ might have been pulled now. That was probably one of the funniest moments I've ever seen. And my second one was we went to Busch Gardens, and you know, when you go to amusement parks, they have long lines, and you know, you rarely find a ride that you can ride twice. Yeah. Well, we found this roller coaster. It was considered a kiddie coaster, but it was amazing. And so we rode on it. We tried to break the record ride as many times as we got. So then we were like, how can we make this even more fun? And we said, let's get Bam and Papa to ride on this roller coaster with us. Now, They didn't ride no rides in none of these amusement parks. Maybe the merry-go-round or the teacups or something like that. And, you know, Papa, when you say something, you stick to it. But, you know, if this is grandkids or, you know, he gonna give eventually. So we're like, come on, ride this roller coaster. Let's ride this ride. It's not that. It's the kiddie coaster. It's the kiddie roller coaster. And, you know, we eventually talk them in, and they get on the ride, and they go up the hill. Mind you, we already know it's coming. So we are cracking up. We're dying. I got my phone over my shoulder, trying to go suspicious. Man, we hit that first hill. Papa was screaming like a little girl. I said, you couldn't tell which one was bad or which one was hot. I mean, it was the funniest thing ever. And the whole time, it was, how did I let y'all kick me? They enjoyed me. They was cracking up on it. But I mean, that was two of the memories that there were many more. But I mean, that was hilarious. I mean, that was hilarious. But I mean, Papa was Papa. I mean, it's funny. Keisha was the first granddaughter, and she named Bama Mother. And then I came along and I named Bama Bama. Then Tyler comes along and he named Bama G. But Papa was Papa, you know, always. And yeah.
Hallelujah. Thank you all. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Amen.
How many of you left such a wonderful legacy? Darlene and Terry are my kids' godparents. And as I watch Mama Hicks and Papa Hicks, I see where their great qualities come from. It's in a whole family. They meet you once and they treat you like family. And I just remember all the cookie bakes that they came in and bite, you know, family. Because they consider everybody that they come in contact with family. But Papa Hicks, he just had this great smile, and he would sit on the couch and just watch everybody. And all the grandkids are just wonderful. His legacy is going to live forever because of the great qualities that they instill in their family. And the grandkids, you got to keep it going for the great grandkids and the ones to come, because it doesn't stop with Papa Hicks. They just the one that started the legacy. But Mama Hicks, I love you dearly. I never really got to know my grandparents, but when I met you guys, I knew that I was blessed to be in contact with the Hicks family. So I thank you for sharing your love and your legacy with me and my family. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to ask those that are going to be sharing in words of expression, if you could come now and just form a line over here. That way we'll know how many we have to receive this morning. If you've got acknowledgments or just words that you'd like to share, you're welcome to come now and form a line over here. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Let me start by saying it all started for us on Edmonton Street in Cleveland, Ohio. Growing up was fun hanging out with my Aunt Beatrice, my Uncle Jimmie, and my cousins across town. I have nothing but positive and wonderful memories of the times when I spent Sundays on Edmonton Street. Every time I would see my uncle, he would hug me and he would say, "How you doing, nephew?" I cannot remember a time when in life when I saw my uncle that he was not happy to see me. You know how it is sometimes when you go home from work and your pet is more happy to see you than your family. More people concerned about what the pet is versus what the person that's been working all day. This certainly wasn't the case for my Uncle Jimmy. He served his country at a time when he was not yet afforded civil rights. He was blessed by the Lord and thus civil in his approach to human beings. I am going to miss his authentic smile and laugh, which cannot be duplicated. Now my uncle always dressed sharp. You all know that. When he stepped out, everyone could tell that he took pride in who he was. And with the young people these days, they would say he was representing. His paying attention to his threads he wore and how he styled and profiled definitely inspired me to strive to achieve his level of elegance and dignity. My brothers and sisters and I remember three boxing trophies my Uncle Jimmy won during his days in the service. That's because his mother, Grandma Maddie Hicks, proudly displayed these on her mantle. So when he was not physically in Grandma and Grandpa's presence, symbolically, their love for their baby son was always on display.
Yeah.
And my Uncle Jimmy and my Aunt Beatrice shared a love of God, love of family, and an unbreakable love as a husband and wife. It was a home of discipline and yet a home of compassion. It was a home where we walked, it was a home where the welcome mat was always there as long as you came to the door with respect for the others. It was a home that was blessed. I always look forward to each Thanksgiving. This is because the Hicks and the Johnson family celebrated this holiday together even before I was born. By the looks of things, we will continue this tradition. I want to thank Jimmy Jr., Jimmy the second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. One year, we would eat over my uncles and enjoy the family's company, and the next year, we'd eat over my mom. This Thanksgiving will be a little different. There will be a void that will hang heavy in my heart. Tears will echo out the wrinkles on my face and stains my soul because I will miss my Uncle Jimmy always being there, glad to see me. I will miss him not being able to hug me and say, how you doing, nephew? We share the holidays together like Memorial Day weekend. I will be with my cousins, brothers, sisters, and my uncle and my mom, and we will go visit graves and various cemeteries to pay tribute to the deceased members in our family. Our two families have been doing this for a long period of time, even before the war. My uncle would always wear his baseball cap with Jesus and bring his shovel, digging hand tools, and lots of rags. We would meet up at the floral store across from Highland View Cemetery where we bought flowers needed to place on each grave. We would visit the graves of relatives on both sides of our families. My uncle would wipe off the graves while my brother Cubby would lift the headstones up, which would let people know that someone remembered that person. This Memorial Day weekend, we will put flowers on the graves of our loved ones who have passed. When I get to my uncle's grave, I will always remember your smile, your goodness, when we lay flowers, freshly watered from our tears, on yours. Thank you.
Sometimes their support, their Sometimes they're laughter, and then there are tears. There was beauty in the bond we shared, and I will always remember reflections of you and me, reflections with everybody, reflections of the love surrounding friends and family, reflections of the good and bad, reflections of the times we had, reflections, memories that I recall. Here, time to say goodbye, but there is still hope. It's a shining light in every act of grief. And although you're not in my arms, not where you should belong, I know you're always here with me because of reflections of you and me. Reflections with reflections of the love surrounding friends and family, reflections of the good and bad, reflections of the love we had, reflections of you and me, memories that I recall.
Sister and his brother, they always been very, very close. And all the years, my dad always talked and loved on his brothers and sisters. I didn't get to spend a lot of time with Uncle Jimmie growing up young, but I always remember the times that I seen him, who he was. And one day, I was on the phone walking in Richmond Mall, talking to my friend, and he was walking around doing his daily walk. And I told my friend, I said, I think that's my daddy brother. So she was like, say something, say something. And I was like, I'm not for sure, but I think that's him. So he went around. When he came back, I stopped him. I was like, excuse me, I think you're my daddy brother. Oh my God, I'm your daddy brother. And probably, I say, every 2 weeks, I visit the mall, and I used to always see Uncle Jimmie, and he used to always give me this great hug. And, you know, he used to always tell me, make sure you take care of your daddy. You know, I don't like to tell him a lot of stuff because I upset him. But y'all take care of your daddy. And I just want to let him know we're going to continue to take care of my daddy. All right. All right.
Thank you. 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 Thank Hicks and Sister Hicks know, we just had a trying music week, but thank God we're here today. And I love you all. And I said, well, we were trying to say, well, where we going? So many things were going on. So I'm so glad I came. What a wonderful legacy. What a wonderful family tie. It's just good to hear. To know how he thought about you. Oh my goodness. Isn't that wonderful for a husband to have those words that you can hold on to? That he thought so much about you. And that's what held the family together. You know, with the head of the, when the man takes his role, it's just wonderful. So I'm so glad I was here, and thank you for allowing me this time. We do have a resolution, but I know nobody in here wants to hear another resolution. So I just never say, when I get inside the game, when I get inside the game, I'll be so happy.
quick. I know we have to move on. But I want to take this opportunity to thank God for this family, for Pastor Hicks and this part of the Lakery District. I want to say that I enjoy Deacon Jimmie Hicks. When I was coming to the doors here at Starlight, I would look at him sometime and how sharp he was dressed. And it was just so one time, he had a tie and a hanky set just like mine. I said, now look at here. What you trying to do here? You trying to dress like the citizen? And I praise God for him. He loved Stacy out of the shoes. And he used to wear this Stacy, and I love Stacy too. And he had such a good heart, such a good spirit. And we praise God. We celebrate him today for the greatness and the time that God has given him. Mother Hicks, we love you all. We love God, right? Keep on praying for us, and keep on, we want to keep on praying for you. This is the time where we need to uphold one another, to uplift one another, because we know that God is able to do all things. God bless
you. At this time, we want to receive thank you, Lord, Imani Hicks with the solo. Come on, give God praise for her as she comes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. Mr. Price, look, take your car about to get towed.
Price. Your license plate says Mr. Price. Verse 4, and said unto them, go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right I will give you. And they went their way. Again he went out about the sixth and ninth hour and did likewise. About the 11th hour he went out and found others standing out idle and said unto them, why stand ye here all the day idle? They said to him, because no man can hire us. And he said unto them, go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right, that shall ye receive. So when even was come, the Lord of the vineyard said to his steward, call the laborers and give them their hire, beginning from the last until the first. And when they came that were hired about the 11th hour, they received every man a penny. But when the first came, they supposed that they should have received more. And they likewise received every man a penny. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and understanding of his word. I don't know why the Lord gave me this. I didn't know why, I know now. Why the Lord gave me this particular passage. It was almost the day I went home after the funeral home came and took my dad. But as I look at this particular parable, Jesus describes a man who was in need of workers in the vineyard. And on his journey on workers, Jesus, he gives us a mental picture of a clock. And on that clock, there are five periods of time. It's early morning, third hour, sixth hour, the ninth hour, and the 11th hour. Reminds me of what Jesus said in Matthew 9:37. He said, the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. When we look at these early morning workers, they received an offer for their work and agreed upon amount for what they were about to do. They had security. They knew what they were going to get. Throughout the whole day, they had security. It's interesting that the third, the sixth, the ninth, and even the 11th hour workers, they did not receive a financial agreement. Instead, they received a statement of faith. I will give you what is right.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but if it was me, I'd be saying, well, right according to what? You know, according to what? I mean, the amount of time that I work, what I produce, or how hard I appear to be working. Y'all know about it. But I believe that they went because there seemed to be enough time to get something accomplished. Those that went at the third hour and the sixth hour and the ninth hour. But I began to think about the one that went at the 11th hour. And I promise I won't have y'all talk to your neighbor, but if y'all could just repeat after me, the 11th hour.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, amen. There's something to be said about someone who will go to work at the 11th hour. If you don't understand what I'm saying, let me bring this home. You go to work from 9 until 6. The 11th hour is 5 o'clock. You know, most of y'all, 5 o'clock, you already straightening up your back. You're looking to hide in the bathroom for those lines that are. The 11th hour is not a productive time. And so when somebody comes and says, come on, I need you to work for me. I don't know about you, but things begin to go through your head. What can I possibly do at the 11th hour? Certainly everything that needs to be done is just about complete at the 11th hour.
and went after 11 hours. Knowing that all he had was a statement of faith. Knowing that he didn't have enough time to build up any equity. He didn't have enough time to build up a day's worth of pay. But he went just the same.
Yes, yes.
A negative person would talk themselves out of doing anything after 11 hours. What's the use? You know, you late for work, you're like, I ain't going. You're only an hour late. I ain't going to hang out. I go tomorrow. But he went at the 11th hour.
Yes.
When it was time to be paid, the Lord of the Almighty said, send me the one that came last first. When it came up to be paid, he received the full day's pay.
Yeah.
That's the word.
Glory to Jesus. Yes. Paid as though he worked the entire day. Others did not agree. But it didn't matter. Because he was paid who was right in the sight
of the Lord.
And so as I look at the marriage of Jimmie and Beatrice Hicks, my mom and my dad, the early morning of that marriage, my mother accepted the call to work in the kingdom of God. But there's something about accepting the call at an early age. You get to do more.
Yeah.
You get to know more.
Yes, sir.
You get to serve more.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You gonna help me here? You gonna help me? I see you over there. I see you. I hear you. And I can say at the third and the sixth and the ninth hours, their children accept the call to go work in the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Doing the best we could.
Yes.
Following the example that we had.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but when you don't have a father that is serving in the kingdom of God as a man, it's hard.
Yes. It's hard.
It's hard because you look at that daddy and he ain't going to church.
Yes. Yes.
And you start figuring, well, why? The men don't go to church. That's just my fault. Then after 11 hours was their marriage. Now look, you got to bring it in perspective. This was a time when he was retired.
Yes.
This was a time when the world would say he was seemingly successful.
Mm-hmm.
You're retired, you got a nice little pension, you know, you've been successful throughout your life. You don't need God. But at the 11th hour, he began working in the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
It didn't just happen like you would imagine it happened. My mom would go to church and he would still be in the bed, and I guess the minute she would shut the door, he'd get up, put his clothes on, and go to the church around the
corner.
And the only reason she waited, she knew, is that she started seeing some programs. Then all of a sudden, his thinking changed about God.
Yeah.
You heard about trips that would take us to Disney World and Hershey Park, but all of a sudden he started taking us on Christian trips. And I'm looking, I'm going, who put this together? We started going to the Sight and Sound Museum. The theater. He started seeing Sarah and Abraham and the beginning of the world started warning us. No, we didn't know when. That's why we said early 2000. We didn't know when. We weren't there, but it was between him and God. God to the poor God had changed. He became faithful. I meant to do the math. I forgot to do the math. So much was on my mind. But we had this church for 7 years and 52 Sundays out of the year. He rarely missed a Sunday getting up through the scripture. It could have been easy for him to say, I'm not going up today. You know, because the first 70 years of my life, I didn't go to church. The first 70 years of my life, even though I seen my wife take my kids and my kids accept Christ, I didn't go. But when he started, he didn't stop. He was faithful. His attitude toward the things of God changed.
Yeah.
I'll never forget when he first was diagnosed with cancer.
Mm.
He came down the stairs and his mother said she had tried to anoint him and he wouldn't let her.
Mm.
I came down with a bottle of oil and I began to put it on his head and I put that stuff on me. So we are children. And we love you. This is what we do.
Yeah.
And he said, and immediately you can see that being put. He said, well, I love my children. Yeah. I love my family. Yeah. So he let me anoint them and he let me pray for them. Yeah. And how do I know his attitude's changed? Because he had a bottle of oil on his dresser. And when his legs were hurt, he just slid them down. Attitude toward giving changed. My mom was one of those preachers that, you know, that man doesn't want my money for his Cadillac. And I ain't giving him nothing. You take that, my mom, take your money, but you ain't taking mine. Boy, I can love God. One of the most faithful tithers that we had. Most faithful deacons. He loved to come up and read the scripture. He loved to come up and collect the offering. And the very first thing he said, you know, God loves
a cheerful
giver. And so I know God is loving on him right now. God for his life. We thank God for everything that he did. We thank God that he was a loving family man. But oh, we truly thank God.
Yeah.
I don't know who reached him. I don't know whose church service he sat in and when he received the call. But I don't even care. I just thank God that he did. Yeah.
him. Hallelujah. That's why it's God's gift. Hallelujah. It's by grace. It's by grace. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. And you in the midst of us today. If you're in the midst of us today, praise God. Hallelujah. Huh? Thank you, Lord. Let this be a witness to you. The Bible says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Whosoever will, let him come. Whosoever that includes you today. Amen. So if you're here today, I just want to encourage you. Find you a Bible preaching, a Bible teaching church. Hallelujah, where the word of God is going forth. Amen. And receive this call, because he's calling you. I want you to know God's calling you today. Amen. He's given us a witness in his house. Bless his holy name.
Family and the interim minister will take place.